Now, atmospheric pressure. See, our earth is surrounded by an envelope of air which is commonly called atmosphere. All of you know that. It is found that the height of atmosphere is approximately 300 kilometers. At some places it is less than 300, some places it is more than 300 kilometers, but approximately 300 kilometers. And since air is a matter and matter exert thrust, that is, it has weight, right? So air applies weight on the earth, and this force exerted by air, that is weight of the earth on a unit surface area, is called atmospheric pressure. Right? And magnitude of atmospheric pressure on surface of earth is, in CGS system, it is 1 gram force per centimeter square, which on calculation is equivalent to 100 Pascal in CGS system. And in SI system, it is 1000 kilogram force per meter square. In this unit, kilogram force per meter square. But if we convert it into Pascal, it is 1 lakh Pascal in SI system. Okay, these are the values of atmospheric pressure. Now, in the next experiment, I'll show you how this experiment show that the atmospheric pressure is very large. It is called crushing can experiment. And what happens in this case is, you know, this is iron can, have a mouth here, and we can have a lid also for this. In this, we put some water inside it and we boil the water. You know, in the beginning, above water, when before boiling, air is there above water inside because it is empty. Only less water is there, so part of the can is empty only. When boiling takes place, steam is formed. Steam pushes the air out of the can. Air is pushed out of the can by steam, and we let the steam come out with a lot of force for some time. Then almost not full, large amount of air is pushed out. So what is there inside now? Steam is there. Then we close this mouth with the cap and we stop heating. Right? Close the mouth with cap and we stop heating. Now what is there inside? Inside steam is there. Then we put a cold water from outside on the can. When we put cold water inside the can, steam condenses and come down. It form liquid and settle down at the bottom. Now because earlier here steam is there, now no steam, no air. Air is already pushed out. So inside a partial vacuum is created. Vacuum. Okay, and that means low pressure is created inside. So inside pressure is low, but you know, outside atmospheric pressure is very large, and large pressure pushes the can inward, and therefore iron can is crushed. So this crushing can experiment simply prove that the atmospheric pressure is actually very large, extremely large pressure. And when you people are drinking that fruity can, and when you suck when the whole of the drink you have already taken, when you suck the air, you can see the fruity can is crushing inward. Because when you suck the air from the fruity can into your mouth, inside low pressure is created and outside high pressure, which crush the fruity can. Same thing happens here, but here it happens at a large scale, right? So this experiment proves that atmospheric pressure is very large. Just for your understanding, I'll say roughly atmospheric pressure is equal to, just imagine if 10,000 kg, roughly 10,000 kg weight is put on your body, how will you feel? 10,000 kg, your body will be crushed, right? So that is the, in a way, roughly, that is the measure of atmospheric pressure. That much pressure we are bearing all the time. Now, measurement of atmospheric pressure. Which instrument is used for measuring atmospheric pressure? That is called barometer. So, barometer is an instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure. Next topic before us is this. We have to make the simple barometer. This barometer, simple barometer, is made by Torricelli. Who made this barometer? Torricelli, right? So what he did, he took 100 centimeter long test tube with a uniform diameter. Diameter is uniform all around, uniform bore. Uniform bore means uniform diameter, 100 centimeter long. And it is thin, not very thick. If you take thick, more mercury you have to add in it. So it was thin only. And mercury is filled in it with lot of care such that there is no air bubble inside it. This is mercury filled in it. Then thumb is placed on the test tube, okay, and another bowl is taken in which mercury is already there. We place the thumb on the test tube and we take it inside the bowl, keeping the thumb on it, and we push our thumb and the test tube inside, okay, inside the mercury, and inside the mercury thumb is removed, right? Then this test tube, of course, there is a stand also which is supporting this test tube. Stand is there, otherwise how it can stand in air? So with the stand it is kept there. Now what is observed here when we do it like this? The earlier the level of mercury is 100 centimeter, but when we put it inside the bowl of mercury, the level of mercury falls and it becomes 76 centimeter or 760 mm of mercury level remains there at sea level. So when we do this experiment at sea level, then this is what is observed. So in the upper part here you can see empty space is there in which there is vacuum, and that vacuum is called Torricellian vacuum. What is it called? Torricellian vacuum. Now you see, what is the pressure acting on the mercury in the bowl? Because mercury in the bowl is in contact with air. So which pressure is acting on the mercury in the bowl? Atmospheric pressure is acting. Clear? And what pressure is acting in the tube from here to here? 76 centimeter of mercury is there. So which pressure is acting in the tube? It is pressure due to 76 centimeter of mercury. So that means atmospheric pressure outside is equivalent to pressure of mercury in the tube. How much mercury is there? 76 centimeter of mercury. Means whatever pressure is applied by our full atmosphere, approximately 300 kilometer of air, height of air above us, is equal to pressure applied by just 76 centimeter of mercury, right? And if you go to some higher places, then pressure decreases. With that, this level of mercury also will decrease. If because of some natural weather phenomena, pressure increases, okay, then pressure of atmosphere increases, then this level of mercury in the barometric tube also increases. So we can say that the atmospheric pressure is proportional to what? Barometric height. Means more the barometric height, more is the atmospheric pressure. Less the barometric height, less is the atmospheric pressure. Clear? And a few more things are here in this paragraph. We can say that pressure exerted by 76 centimeter of vertical height of mercury column, already I've explained, is equal to what? Pressure exerted by air column at the surface of mercury in the bowl. I've told you, pressure acting on the surface is atmospheric pressure, is equal to pressure applied by the mercury in the barometric tube. So that's why I have given this relation to you, that more the barometric height means height of mercury in the barometric tube. That is barometric height. More the barometric height, more is the atmospheric pressure at that place. Less barometric height means less atmospheric pressure at that place. नेक्स्ट इज वेरिएशन इन एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. वेरिएशन इन एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. इट इज फाउंड दैट विद द चेंज इन हाइट, सीजन एंड टेम्परेचर एटसेट्रा द बैरोमेट्रिक प्रेशर चेंजेस विच सजेस्ट दैट एयर प्रेशर ऑल्सो चेंजेस. एयर प्रेशर ऑल्सो चेंजेस राइट. नाउ विद हाइट, सीजन, टेम्परेचर, बैरोमेट्रिक प्रेशर चेंजेस विच दैट सजेस्ट दैट एयर प्रेशर ऑल्सो चेंजेस बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस बैरोमेट्रिक प्रेशर मीन्स बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. इफ बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट चेंजेस एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर ऑल्सो विल चेंज. इफ द बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट इज लेस देन 76 वी कैन से एयर प्रेशर हैज फॉलन. इफ द बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट इज मोर देन 76 देन वी कैन से एयर प्रेशर हैज इंक्रीज्ड. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द फैक्टर्स ऑन विच बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट मीन्स हाइट ऑफ मर्करी इन द बैरोमेट्रिक ट्यूब डिपेंड्स. ओके फर्स्ट डज नॉट डिपेंड इंडिपेंडेंट. द बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ टू पॉइंट्स. फैक्टर्स ऑन विच बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट डज नॉट डिपेंड मीन्स इंडिपेंडेंट. देर आर टू फैक्टर्स. वर्टिकल हाइट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ शेप और साइज ऑफ द ट्यूब. सी बेटा यू कैन टेक दिस ट्यूब बैरोमेट्रिक ट्यूब लाइक दिस. इफ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन टेक वेरी थिक बैरोमेट्रिक ट्यूब ऑल्सो वेरी थिक वन बट इट शुड बी 100 centimeter लॉन्ग. यू कैन टेक अ बैरोमेट्रिक ट्यूब ऑफ एनी शेप. यू कैन टेक अ शेप लाइक दिस ऑल्सो नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल बट हाइट वर्टिकल हाइट शुड बी 100 centimeter. सो शेप एंड साइज विल नॉट अफेक्ट द बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट. वर्टिकल बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट वेन वी आर सेइंग बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट इट मीन्स वर्टिकल बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट दैट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ शेप एंड साइज. Secondly, it does not change if the tube is tilted. See here you can see tube is tilted. But you know barometric vertical height is same in all cases. Vertical height does not change. Although this inclined height can be more or less. Here less. In this case it will be more. But vertical height will not change. Right? This point, second point, sometimes it is called hydrostatic paradox also. Hydrostatic paradox that vertical height does not change, inclined height that will increase or decrease, but vertical height remains same. So two factors are there on which barometric height of mercury in the simple barometer does not depend, independent. Now next five factors we'll discuss which affect barometric height. Which affect barometric height. So first factor is presence of moisture in the mercury. See if in the mercury, see this is a mercury, in the mercury moisture is present. Moisture is present and you know here vacuum is there, Torricelli vacuum, right? And inside mercury moisture is present and you know moisture, water under vacuum condition evaporate more. Evaporation is faster and more under vacuum condition in case of water. So water vapors evaporate and they are collected here in the Torricellian part, vacuum part. And you know vapors are gas and gas apply pressure and this gas will push the mercury level in the barometric tube downward. Means mercury level decreases. Height of mercury decreases, barometric height decreases if moisture is present in the mercury. But you know this barometric decrease in barometric height is not because of atmospheric pressure outside. Atmospheric pressure outside doesn't change. Then why barometric height falls? That is because of impurity is present. What, which impurity is there? Moisture is present here. So presence of moisture is responsible for decrease in barometric height. So if somebody is saying what is the effect on barometric height if moisture is present in mercury, so what's your answer? Barometric height drops. So your answer is barometric height drops. Why this barometric height drops? Reason is there रीजन फॉर द फॉल इन प्रेशर इज दैट लिक्विड मीन्स वाटर वेपराइजेस इन द वैक्यूम एंड द वेपर्स देन एग्जर्ट फोर्स ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ मर्करी देयर बाय फोर्सिंग इट डाउन मीन्स बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट डिक्रीजेस. देन क्वेश्चन अराइजेस व्हाट इज द प्रेशर ऑफ द वेपर्स. What is the pressure of water vapors which are applied on the level of mercury in the barometric tube? So that vapor pressure is given by true atmospheric pressure, which we can measure by some other barometer which does not have moisture in it. So that will give true barometric pressure. From that pressure, subtract the barometric pressure given by faulty barometer which have moisture in it. Subtract that. And this difference will give you pressure of the water vapors present in the torricellian vacuum. So this is first factor. Three things you have to learn from here. Name of the factor. Secondly, what is the effect on barometric height? It drops. Third, reason for that. Fourth, how you calculate pressure of vapors. So four things you have to learn from this point. Next is presence of dissolved metal in the mercury. If this mercury have impurities, dissolved metals are there, zinc, lead, tin is there. You know, zinc, lead, tin have less density than mercury. Density of mercury is 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. Lead is 11.6. Zinc and tin also have less density than that. If impurities are present, means in heavy material mercury, lighter things are present. This makes the mercury overall lighter. If in heavier material, some lighter things are put, suppose in a 9th standard student, they have a lot of weight. And if among the 9th standard students, we put some nursery kids, lighter ones, then average weight of the class will go down or not? It will go down, average will decrease. Here, there I am talking about weight, but here it is density. If in denser material mercury, if impurities are lighter one, having less density, then overall density of that sample of mercury will come down. Right? And you know, we know pressure applied by mercury in the barometric column is given by H mercury, rho mercury, G. H mercury, height of mercury, rho mercury, density of mercury into G, that is acceleration due to gravity. If density is less because of metals present, impurities present in it, this will decrease the pressure applied by mercury in the barometric tube. But you know, outside atmospheric pressure is there, that is still large. To balance the pressure outside, okay, the height of mercury in the column should increase. We have already told you, see, whatever is the atmospheric pressure, same is the pressure applied by mercury in the barometric tube. Same pressure is applied. Suppose outside pressure is 1 lakh. Just one example, 1 lakh Pascal. Then some H is there, rho is there, G you leave. It is constant, so leave. We will not discuss. Product of all these three will be equal to 1 lakh. If G decreases, rho G, density of mercury decreases because of impurities present in it. If density decreases, therefore overall this product will come down. But you know, we have to make this product equal to 10 lakh, 1 lakh. So what we can do here so that the product should remain 1 lakh, because atmospheric pressure outside is not changing. It is the problem of mercury which is there in barometer, not the change in any atmospheric pressure outside. So if density decreases, then there is corresponding increase in height of the mercury in the barometric tube. Okay, height of barometric tube will correspondingly increase such that overall the product remains 1 lakh. Now I'll give you very simple example. Pressure is 1 lakh, say height is 100, just for your sake I'm giving. Density is say 100, right? And value of G is 10. So see, overall the two sides are equal. I'm taking rough value, they are not real values. Now by some problem, suppose this value, that is density, is made 50 unit. 10 will not change. You know, if this is 50, then what is the product? It becomes 50,000, but it is not 1 lakh, right? But you know, this does not change, this is still 1 lakh. Then how we can make both sides equal? We can make both sides equal if this height 100, that should be made 200. If it is 200, 200 into 10, 2000, 2000 into 50, 1 lakh. Now again both sides are equal. Means if one factor on the right side will decrease, then the other factor will automatically increase. But that factor cannot be G, because G at a place is constant. So when density of liquid decreases, then the corresponding height of mercury in the barometer will increase. So that overall the pressure applied by mercury in the barometer should be equal to atmospheric pressure outside. Do you understand? So whenever density of mercury because of some impurities falls, then the corresponding height of mercury in barometric tube will increase. So what you have to learn now, reason I have given, what you have to learn, when metals are present, then you know barometric height will increase. Barometric height will increase the corresponding height of mercury. Barometric height will increase. Why? Because density of mercury decreases, this will increase the corresponding barometric height, so that atmospheric pressure applied by mercury in barometer should be equal to pressure applied by mercury in barometer should be equal to atmospheric pressure outside. Clear? So again, few things you have to learn. Factor, barometric height increases, and the reason for that. Clear? But again, the reading given by this barometer also will be faulty. So these two are faults of barometer. Now something happens in the atmosphere outside, means barometer is correct, no moisture in the barometer, no impurities in the barometer, but you know the barometer is taken from less height to more height, from sea level to some higher altitude. When barometer is taken to some higher altitude, I'll show you, if a barometer is taken to some higher altitude, then what happens? See, this is sea level, and suppose from sea level water is taken to some higher altitude, and this is the boundary of the atmosphere, 300 kilometer. Here if you check, the height of air column is very large at sea level, and because height of air column is very large, that is why atmospheric pressure is maximum at sea level. But when you go to higher altitude, then the height of the place of course will increase from sea level, but what I'm talking about is height of air column decreases at higher altitude. Air is having less height now, and when air have less height, okay, then atmospheric pressure falls. Outside atmospheric pressure decreases. That is why when you go from sea level to some higher altitude, pressure decreases. At higher altitude, mountain areas, pressure is less. When atmospheric pressure is less, beta, then automatically barometric height also will be less. That is, barometric height decreases. So what is the effect of vertical height from sea level? With the increase in vertical height from sea level, atmospheric pressure decreases, and therefore barometric height also falls. Why falls? Because already I have discussed, barometric height is proportional to what? Is proportional to atmospheric pressure. मोर बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट मोर एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, मोर एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर मोर बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट, लेस बैरोमेट्रिक प्रेशर लेस बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट. सो एट हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर डिक्रीजेज विद दैट बैरोमेट्रिक हाइट ऑल्सो डिक्रीजेज. नाउ कम टू टेम्परेचर ऑफ एटमोस्फियर. सी इफ टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर इंक्रीजेज राइजेज विद दैट डेंसिटी ऑफ एयर डिक्रीजेज. Density of air is less. If pressure, temperature increases, density of air decreases. And what is atmospheric pressure? P air, atmospheric pressure is applied by air only. P, H rho G. So atmospheric pressure is H air rho air G. If temperature increases with that, density of air will decrease. Air becomes lighter. When density of air decreases with that atmospheric pressure decreases. When atmospheric pressure decreases then barometric height also decreases because barometric height is proportional to atmospheric pressure only. So here also barometric height will decrease. Barometric height also will decrease because of increase in atmospheric pressure temperature. Okay, temperature increases with that density of air decreases, hence atmospheric pressure decreases, therefore barometric height also decreases. And reverse happens if the temperature falls. If temperature falls then density of air increases. Okay, when density of air increases atmospheric pressure increases, hence barometric height also will increase. Right, so therefore fall in barometric height indicate that decrease in pressure is there, and decrease in pressure sometime indicate there is fall in, there is increase in temperature. Temperature increases means. So they are all interrelated. Last factor is presence of moisture in air. You know, again air have a density quite 1.29 density is there on the average. So air particles are there, heavier particles are there in air. But you know, if in the air lighter particle moisture, see vapor density of air is 14.4 or 14.6, but water is 9 only. So water vapors are lighter than air. Water vapor, I'm not saying water is lighter, I'm saying water vapors are lighter than air. So if more moisture is there in the air, lighter things are there in the air, naturally the density of air will be less. If density of air is less, with that atmospheric pressure is less because P is equal to H rho G. If rho density of air is less, with that atmospheric pressure is less. Now if atmospheric pressure is less, naturally barometric height again falls. So more is the moisture present in air, less is its density. With the decrease in density of the air, atmospheric pressure decreases, thus barometric height also decreases. So what is the effect of moisture in the mercury? Barometric height decreases. Why? Reason is given here. What is the effect of increase in temperature? Barometric height falls. What is the reason? Reason is given here. What is the effect of increase in vertical height? Barometric height falls. Why? Reason is given here. So reason you have to learn and the effect on the barometric height you have to learn in this part. Clear? Next, expressing atmospheric pressure in pascals. Why atmospheric pressure is, how we can express atmospheric pressure in pascals? It's very easy. See, we know this is the formula for atmospheric pressure. P is equal to H rho G. H at sea level, what is the height? 76 centimeter. If you divide by 100, it is 76 by 100 meter. Density of mercury is 13,600. Value of G is, in your book, you have taken 9.8. If you multiply all these, you will get this answer, 101300 Pascal roughly. After multiplication, do yourself. Now just move the decimal which is here, 1 place, 2 place, 3 place, 4 place, 5 place. So it is 1.013 10 raised to the power 5 Pascal. okay? So this is your atmospheric pressure. So by putting the value of h in meters, density in kilogram per meter cube, and value of g in meter per second square, you will get answer at pressure, atmospheric pressure in Pascal. So we can easily convert barometric height into Pascals by this method, right? But question arises, why is barometric pressure expressed in terms of, always expressed in terms of centimeter of mercury? We are saying, what is the atmospheric pressure? 76 centimeter of mercury. What is the atmospheric pressure, sir? 72 centimeter of mercury, or 70 centimeter of mercury, or 78 centimeter of mercury. Why atmospheric pressure is expressed in centimeter of mercury in place of Pascals? Although we can convert, but why it is expressed in centimeter of mercury? Why not in terms of Pascal directly? So reason for that is here, you know, we know atmospheric pressure is equal to pressure of mercury in the barometer. And pressure of mercury in the barometer is equal to height of mercury, density of mercury into g. You know, g at a place is constant. So barometric pressure applied by mercury depends on three factors: h, rho, g. But g at a place is constant. Density of mercury in the barometer will not change. If it is pure mercury, so density will remain same. Okay, then which factor is left on which mercury pressure depends? Height of mercury. One factor is left, right? So mercury pressure depends on height of mercury, and on mercury pressure, atmospheric pressure depends. So atmospheric pressure depends on mercury pressure of barometer, and mercury pressure of barometer depends on height of mercury in the barometer. So that is why atmospheric pressure is expressed in terms of height of mercury in the barometer. So let us see what they are saying. Since density of mercury and acceleration due to gravity at a given place are constant, therefore pressure is proportional to height of mercury in the barometer. Hence, we can express pressure in terms of height of mercury column.